Hello Aries, welcome new viewers, cross watchers and my lovely moonians. Thank you so much for being here. This is a mid-monthly reading for Jan 2020. So let's see what's coming through. We have dreams coming through with the Nine of Cups. This is a really nice energy which is coming through reorganization and the self-belief which is coming in and manifestations too. Rewards will be coming in is what is coming through. Something which you were waiting upon, wishing upon is going to come true, and this is also talking about be careful what you wish for because it may just become true, that kind of a thing. But overall, this is in essence, this card talks about someone feeling satisfied that their hard work has paid off and the results, rewards, recognition coming through. We have Just Breathe coming in reverse with the Four of Swords over here, which is talking about take time to rest. Don't stress about things. Your rewards will be coming in majorly, which is coming through over here, especially on projects that you've really put in your effort, like really put in a lot of time, a lot of your ideas, something which is like a baby to you will be flourishing, that kind of a thing. We have coming together with the Two of Cups in reverse. This is talking about there's a need to just relax a little in case there is certain kind of conflict which is happening, whether it is internally or with your partner. We need to relax a little. It will all pan out. Maybe divine timing is at work, is the energy which is coming through, but avoid any kind of confrontation, especially if you feel wounded. Don't react impulsively is the energy which is coming through over here. Avoid confrontation unless and until it is something which is really, really vital. That kind of energy is coming in. But yes, I personally, what I would do is like, if I'm feeling emotional about something and I'm getting clearer about what I want and the situation is not really in sync with what I'm feeling, I will go and talk to the person. Irrespective, I win the conversation or lose the conversation. But it is very important not to do it impulsively. Do the confrontation, have the conversation as and when required, but at least have a clear idea and go have a heart-to-heart with a clear mind is what is coming through. We have confront coming in reverse with the Sun strength card coming in reverse over here. I do see a little in terms of emotionally, I see that there's certain kind of discomfort which is happening, not being able to see the reality or trying to run away or kind of wearing the rosy tinted glasses, but not really that much. I feel that it is all going away. The illusionary veil is going away and reality is coming through. So maybe that's why we have a little bit of upheaval which is going on, making one feel a little unstable in terms of someone who is really fearing what the outcome will be. That kind of energy is coming in, which is why the Major Arcana, Leo Major Arcana, is coming through and telling you, irrespective of what is coming in, know that you have the emotional strength and the increasing intuition to overcome it. You have the fortitude. Keep going forward. Your dreams will be coming true. We have Manifest Magician card coming in reverse. Be aware of certain kind of manipulation that may be going on, or even inner saboteur, which tends to become very negative and undervaluing ourselves. Don't do that, because you are coming into a phase of your life where you will be manifesting your thoughts as well. Your dreams, yes, but your thoughts as well. So become aware of that. This is someone who has a lot of potential, who has a lot of power, but at the very end of it, he or she is not being able to utilize it, because there's certain kind of underconfidence which may be playing out, which is coming through all over here. Breathe. Breathe is what is coming in. Breathe in the confidence. Breathe out the negativity and the doubts. Anxiety needs to go is what is coming through. This is a Sagittarian energy which comes through, and a bit of Gemini as well. So be aware of people who are a little flamboyant and don't necessarily always showcase what they're truly feeling, that kind of a thing. If there is any kind of mask, kind of a discernment which is happening, become aware of it is also what is coming through. And have a heart-to-heart conversation in case you feel there's certain kind of deception which is going on and has been going on for a long time. All right? We have giving and receiving coming through, which is a really lovely energy with the Six of Pentacles. This is talking about having enough resources yourself that you will be able to show compassion, share, and even charity work. This is what it talks about. But yes, in a certain way, this is also talking about bringing the balance in the give and take. This is a time that you will be receiving, and also you have plenty. Before you can give it to anyone else, you need to make sure that your own resources, whether it is finances, whether it is love, whether it's just pure energy, make sure that you have a protective layer already there for you, protecting your inner energy while you extend it to others. But overall, this is a really, really nice energy which talks about of a person who is very sharing, very caring. People come to this person even for their advice, but more so for their help, kind of a thing. They feel very nice helping others. That kind of energy is coming in. There's a divine feminine energy which is really rising, especially if you have been hiding away. The divine feminine has been hiding away and not really coming through and showcasing who she or he really is. We also have Observe coming in with the Hanged Man coming in reverse, which is talking about a little bit of chaos which may be going on in someone's mind, not being able to decide or go forward and feeling the procrastination happening. Someone who is not being able to come to a point where they can decide what they really want, and because of that, they are still staggering or trying to hang in there. And this person is getting a little anxious about where is this going, kind of energy is coming through. So instead of confronting like with anger or frustration or irritation, let's calm ourselves down and then initiate this conversation, which is highly due. All right, we have Faith with number 5 coming in reverse. This is talking about having more trust in your own self, and of course about having trust, having faith in the universe that what is meant for you will be coming through. Sometimes an extra pause in our life comes in so that we can observe what is happening, reflect a little, avoid self-criticism, because we also have Saturn going into Capricorn after 2.5 years of being in Sagittarius, which caused things to get delayed, a little bit of lethargy which is coming in. And now is the time where things will be set right. Organizing, critical analysis will also be happening, but make sure that the analysis doesn't stagnate you. Do what is right for you. We have King of Cups also coming over here like this. I'll keep it this way and I will be talking the plus, pros and cons, like upright and reverse over here. This is someone who's trying to make things work, who is very emotional, who likes to express themselves. But when it comes in reverse, this person becomes doubtful and kind of feels a little disappointed for the recognition not coming through, and feels undermined or not enough attention is being given to this person. That kind of a thing. Wherein this person, it may be like, you know, some people are just too busy in their own life that they're not really realizing how it is affecting you. So it is important to let the other person know and have a conversation with an open mind so that you can listen to what they have to say. I feel that, like, you know, these cards, the major arcanas coming the way they have been coming through, it is talking about a little bit of drama, emotional drama, which may be going on because of someone's confusion that they are not being able to take concrete decisions, and it's really driving this person crazy in a certain way. So see, what do you really want? Because this person will continue to be a little confused, because I feel they have gotten a little comfortable in the way things have been. So you have to be careful how you're handling it and completely avoid being aggressive about it, because that way this person will go into their own shell, kind of a thing, and nothing will come out of it apart from defense mechanism, and you don't really want that. You want this person to stay there, stand, look you in the eye and really speak the truth. All right, so we have blossoming abundance coming through. Emotionally, there's certain kind of anxiety which is coming in, and this need not be for the romance. It could be some family member or friend also. But at the other end, the universe is just telling you there are abundance. Your dreams will be coming true. So could also be like, you know, there are a few scenarios which are coming through. Could be that you realize that this is not really what you want, and you then make space by releasing certain things, closing certain chapters and moving forward, picking up yourself and moving forward. Apart from that, maybe a little bit more clarity as to where you think you should be going with the relationship will give them some direction and inspiration to pick things up and come along with you, that kind of a thing as well. But moreover, at this time, the universe is saying whatever you have wished for and worked towards, they will all be coming true. And perhaps a bit of the choices you have made, the seeds you have sowed in the past, you are getting the harvest right now. That kind of energy is coming in. So let's become aware and see how we can alter a few things if in case they are not really in sync with what you really want. We have financial constraints also coming in. Again, this is talking about don't stress about the money, and there is this essence of there is recognition, promotion, which will be coming in, abundance, which will be coming through. And this may be a time to refine your goals also. How are you going ahead? Strategize a little is also what is coming through. With the Six of Pentacles over here, this is talking about in a way like, you know, like if you see rich people or people who are financially sound or even people who are not really, everyone has their own standards of feeling satisfied. So I'm not going to say more or less, but a person who is satisfied with what he has or she has, because they already value what is already there in their life. And even no matter how fat your check is or however meager you may be earning, but still being able to give another person who is more in need, that kind of a thing. And suddenly Jane Austen came through. I wanted to say something about it, but I'll refrain from saying it. But anyways, it's a very good thing. It was a positive example that I was giving. But anyways, what I'm seeing over here, what I wanted to say is like, you know, like as simple as if I take the example of rich people, they give money out to the world because they feel that they have enough. So, and they know that there will be new ways of gaining money also. There, like, money is not something that worries them. And that is only the thing which I'm saying to take from it, is what I'm trying to say, although I'm taking a long time to say it, because there's a little bit of stressful energy which is overly playing, and it's like, just tell me about the emotion, tell me about the love department and not all of this right now. I can't think about the philosophical things because I want to know what on earth, what the hell is going on with this person. That is coming through again and again. Stressing is not going to help you at all. And if you feel that you are expecting a little more respect and love from another person, that there in itself is telling you, is an indicator that the love and respect that you expect from others, start giving it to yourself. And with that fulfilling energy, you will be changing what you are attracting into your life, is also something which is coming through. Now, coming back to the financial constraints over here, yes, budgeting will be very nice. Don't go on splurging crazily at the moment. It is just advised. It's your choice. Because I do see, like, you know, don't worry about things. This one comes through only to tell you that worrying is not really going to help. Any kind of pause that comes through from the universe is a chance for you to observe the value already there. Like, money is just a commodity. It may be a means of happiness, but not happiness itself. There's more value in time, love, and tranquility too. So breathe. Tap into, this is also a very nice time to connect with your emotional world, because we started this half with the full moon and lunar eclipse, penumbral lunar eclipse in Cancer. which exposed our vulnerable side and made us more emotional, sensitive. So this kind of a reckoning is only coming in so that you can really get in touch with what is really happening. And is it connecting? Is your reality connecting with what your heart truly desires? And if there is certain kind of deviation there, then how can we make it towards where we want to go? Is something which comes through. We have, see again, all these cards. Dreams coming true, blossoming abundance, and now frog with prosperity also coming in. So don't really stress about this thing. Or could be that the other person is stressing about it, like, you know, money-wise also, not feeling that their work is getting recognized and they're feeling a little too concerned or undervalued right now, and their focus is going completely on the finances. Anyways, this says, let go of the past and embrace change. Opportunities are close at hand. Hop into this new day with joy. Abundance and good fortune await you. There's a mentality change which is coming in. A law of attraction, yes, but understanding the meaning of wealth and knowing that you are wealthy. And wealth is just not financial. It is about health. It is about putting in more care in the bonds that you have created in your life, giving out compassion, acting with compassion, and, like, you know, surrounding yourself with positive energy, with people who truly love you, who care for you, and vice versa. Like, it's wholesome which is coming through over here. So if you feel stuck, blocked, creatively blocked in any way, don't push yourself to see the solution. Sometimes it is also very important to just step back and stop taking other people's input and really tune into yourself and see what do you really want. Or sometimes when we're focusing, if I have my face over here with my eyes that close to the pine, after like 10 minutes max to max, my eyes will really start paining. Sometimes what is required is to go a little back, take a breather, look here and there, rest, rejuvenate, and then see things. And that way you will be able to analyze the whole thing more efficiently. We have unicorn, infinite possibilities coming through. I am really, really liking the energies because the higher spiritual realm is talking about all the things which will be coming true. And perhaps in the current situation, in the 3D realm, you can't really see it. But clearly I see there are things and things waiting for you, surprises, good news, celebrations waiting for you in the wings. Universe is working behind the wings and you don't really know about it. And there are major changes and surprises which will be coming in. So embrace the transformation and go with the flow, because this is about all about ascension. Whether it is about raising your standards, valuing yourself more, valuing what you already have, and trying to look at things in a different way with a higher perspective, that kind of a thing. But all of this is just telling you to continue doing what you're doing. And like in terms of your passionate projects also, and do what is really true to you, because your intuition is also guiding you towards your higher good. So embrace that and do that. Is what is coming through. With the infinite possibilities and the unicorn, this says, you are the sovereign of the seen and unseen worlds. The magic of love surrounds you. Beauty transforms you. Listen to the spirits of light. Abandon the darkness. These things are more, it's almost like someone is awakening and maybe feeling that they're going through a dark tower moment, stormy time. Dark night of the soul kind of a thing, where this person over here, even divine masculine, will realize that these things are important. Like materialistic aspects of this physical world are important. But at the end of it, if I'm not feeling satisfied emotionally or in my soul, what is the point of all of this? Whatever is superficial, why do I keep it so close to myself that I have to portray a certain thing? I need to be myself. It's almost like letting loose a little, letting your soul speak, that kind of energy which is coming through over here. This also says, go beyond the ordinary and become the legendary. Letting go of the toxic environments or things, situation, aspects, circumstances which have kept you hostile, because you know there is a spirit of courage brimming within you and you are ready to make space for abundance to come your way, prosperity to come your way. The darkness is going. The chilly winter is going. You can lift your head up because the dawn is coming through and bringing in newness into your life, where you will be able to manifest all your dreams into a waking reality. This is almost like a wake-up call coming from the divine over here. You know that you have a higher calling and it is time now to let go of the resistance. Yes, sometimes you'll feel that you don't really want to do it. Maybe that's why that uncomfortable energy is coming in. What will I feel? What will that vacuum feel like when I make the change? Will I be able to do it? And this is saying, yes, you will be rewarded. Just take that one step and then eventually you will really embrace it and really enjoy the whole process of it. This is if you want to really see yourself achieve the things you want, you so desire. This is a step up from the universe coming through. It is testing you whether or not you are ready for it. And it's now time to show that you are ready to shine. All right. So that is what is coming through. Do let me know if this resonated. It's a very charged up, really nice push from the universe which is coming in. Your higher self and the universe is guiding you towards the next step because they are pretty much vital. So help the universe help you and God bless you all. Until next time, many, many abundant possibilities and beautiful blessings to you all. Om Namah Shivaya. Keep that vibe high, my lovely moonians.